She's just a girl and she's on fire. Hotter than a fantasy. Lonely like a highway.
Entertaining, informative, proactive, fun. The new Spice Mornings with Janice. Tell everyone to tune in.
Spice Morning for today, Monday. Well, it is the 18th day of November. The month seems to be going so quickly. Well, whatever you did this weekend, I hope you enjoyed yourself. I know there was quite a bit of activity, you know, with this weekend being a payday weekend for the fortnightly workers. I know there was quite a bit of entertainment, but whatever you did, whether it was just your spiritual revitalization, whether you spent some time doing a little bit of gardening or just catching up with the chores around the house, some of you it was just rest and relaxation. But whatever it was, I hope you had a great weekend and that you're looking forward to taking on the challenges of this week. A special good morning to the folks up there in St. Patrick, and of course not forgetting those of St. Mark, and of course St. John. Not forgetting those of you in Big Parish St. Andrew. Good morning to you, my folks up there in Pearl, St. Andrew, all over St. Andrew. Good morning to you. And of course not forgetting those of you in St. David. A special good morning to the folks up there in St. David. And of course St. George's, I like to call it the melting pot of diversity, man. All of the different cultures and everything happening down in St. George's. Good morning to you. If you're just waking up out of bed, well, I envy you. This me, it was particularly tough getting out of bed, but you know, a girl's got to do what a girl's got to do. So here I am, ready to entertain you this morning, the elderly of the nation. A special good morning to you, the students. How y'all doing? I know it is time you're getting ready for your exams. Yes, you have that end of term exam, and it's a very important one. So I hope you are taking it seriously. You need good grades, you know that. So special good morning to you. Well, in terms of some of the things, just a recap on some of the things which took place over the weekend. Of course, the Wagiti football knockout that would have taken place on Saturday, and you would have seen that, heard that there were performances by people like Bungie Gallen and Little Vaughn and Boise and all of these guys. From all reports, it seems as if things went very, very well down there at the National Stadium. I didn't get around to going down there, but I understand that it was really, really good. And I have some results here for you. I understand that Hurricanes, well, they beat Rangers. And we also had the Boca Junior boys beating, that is the Grenada Boys Secondary School, on penalties. Last Saturday, it was just some matches between the boys, the men. I believe next weekend the girls would be playing. And I caught something. It was almost like a Spice Morning I saw. On Saturday, I visited the Richmond Home for the Elderly on Saturday, and I saw some folks from the Republic Bank, and they were up there. You know, they brought some food hampers for the home, and of course the Republic Bank harps, they were up there and entertaining the clients, I should say, or the people living in the home. And I thought that was really, really a nice gesture, people taking the time to care for other people, you know, because these persons, a lot of them do not have any family or relatives to visit them, and just having people come come around and do something nice for them. It is such a great thing. So again, I applaud the folks of the Republic Bank and of course the Harps doing their little piece to bring a little cheer around this season. Well, yesterday was a big day, and of course it was the convention that is of the new National Party, and I visited part of that, and something caught my attention in terms of the presentation made by our Prime Minister. He spoke about forgiveness. I'd share this with you this morning because it doesn't matter who you support or what you support, forgiveness is important because it's a message that comes, you know, straight from the Almighty. And forgiveness is such an important thing. And he said that to forgive is to emancipate yourself. What a strong word, but so very profound. It says here that those who hate are troubled, and they are the ones that are being uncomfortable. They are miserable. When you hate and you refuse to forgive and you refuse to move on from that hatred, you are the one that is suffering. You know, the high blood pressure keep going up and you're constantly worried, constantly troubled. So to forgive is really to release yourself and to lay down your burdens, preferably at the cross, eh? Yes, so he spoke about that, and there were quite a number of observers from different diplomatic corps throughout, and I thought it was a very, very nice event indeed. So again, folks, whatever you did this weekend, I really hope you accomplished what you set out to accomplish. And this week, as I said, you will just do what you have to do with renewed vigor and renewed strength. Hopefully, I know it's the Christmas season is just around the corner. If you tune on your radio, man, you're being blasted, as I say, with Parang music left, right, and center, man. And I've been listening a lot to Fat Man George. I like the one about being a savior. He said this year he's a savior, man, because over the years, you know, he's been spending all of his money and buying gifts and buying all kind of things for everybody, and nobody's reciprocating. So this year he's a savior. Perhaps it's an approach that many of us need to take, you know, in these goo days, I say. Anyways, let's take a break, and when we come back, it's going to be the Bible quote for today.
Canadians are resilient, tough, especially when the going gets rough. Bouncing back from Ivan and Emily is just part of that rich tradition of fortitude. Now we're here again, riding the turbulent waves of an economic downturn until we rise again. Everyone's called to play a part in the recovery process. The IMF and the World Bank have agreed to help, and friendly countries will provide grants and soft loan. Therefore, let's show them that we're also prepared to help ourselves. As a proud nation, let's all play our part. From paying our taxes to other forms of sacrifice, we can influence nation building and hasten the economic recovery. As patriotic Grenadians, we're all aboard for Operation Recovery.
Hey, Grenada to the world. The Government Information Service continues its journey, reaching out to new platforms, highlighting public issues, and the work of government in action. A new glitzy website has been launched to achieve the goal of sharing information to readers and viewers everywhere. News.gov.gd is the new GIS website, updated constantly with information, capturing progress in government, reports, press releases, pictures, newsletters, news on demand, live GIS TV online streaming, GIS TV and radio programs, the popular Spice Morning with Janice, constantly updating and informing on public information. You can also download the GIS TV app on iTunes Store and Google Play for free, straight onto your Android smartphone or Apple iPhone. News.gov.gd is new glitzy website. Log on.
It's a beautiful morning.
Well, it is now time for the Bible quote for today. Even as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them in like manner, giving themselves over to fornication and going after strange flesh, are set forth for an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire. That scripture is taken from Jude chapter 1 and verse 7. Welcome back to Spice Morning, in case you are just joining us. Well, it's good to have you tuned in. We are going to move straight into the word for today, and today it is coming to you, well, the word for today and did you know, and today it is coming to you through the compliments of the students of the Woburn Methodist School.
Hello everyone, we the students of the Woburn Methodist School would like to share with you virtues that can assist with character development. The virtue for today is trustworthiness. Trustworthiness is being worthy of trust. People can count on you and to do your best and to follow through on your commitments. Others can rely on you. They can trust that if it is at all possible, you will do what you said. You will do even if it becomes really hard. One, my word. Two, I am worthy of the trust others place in me. Three, I am trustworthy. I am credible. And remember, the virtue for today is trustworthiness.
Hello everyone. We, the students of the Woburn Methodist School, are proud to share with you some magic facts. I am Colangelo. One, did you know that the lobster takes approximately 7 years to grow to be a pound? Two, did you know that the common goldfish is the only animal that can see both infrared and ultraviolet light? Three, did you know that there are only three animals with blue tongues? The black bear, the chow dog, and the blue-tongued lizard. Join us today for a word for today, or did you know? I am Kalan. It's so good to know.
That was the students of the Woburn Methodist School. Very, very nice indeed. Trustworthiness. That is, people can rely on you. You are worthy. You follow through and you do the things that you say that you will do. Very, very important. Food for thought. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We are moving straight into the healthy lifestyle tip. And on a daily basis, it comes to you through the compliments of the folks at the Grenada.